So welcome all to this lecture 2, Self-Exploration as the Process for Value Education. So we'll spend some time on the topics that are regarding self-exploration. Some of the formulations are new in the sense that you have perhaps not seen them in the 5-day workshop. And if they have been covered, please let me know so that we'll go to the questions related to those formulations. So if you look at what this course or this workshop is, it's a process of dialogue that starts between me and you, between the facilitator and the participant. But that's not where it stops. It soon becomes a dialogue within your own self. And that is the self-exploration that we intend through this whole workshop to actually happen. It's not just a matter of a transfer of some information, but the deeper meaning or the deeper purpose of this workshop or this course is so that this dialogue, the self-exploration can begin in the student, in the participant, so that they are able to answer their own questions by themselves, find the right answer or find the right placement of their question and find the right answer on their own right. And this has been discussed briefly earlier also, so I won't go much into detail of this, but to mention some of the key points, that the dialogue is between what I am and my natural acceptance. Yes, is there any problem, anybody? Okay.
Voice is perfectly okay, bhaiya.
Yeah, there was some background noise, so I stopped for a minute. So if you look at this dialogue within, it is a dialogue between what I am and what I really want to be. It is between my imagination and my natural acceptance, between my desire, thought, and expectation, and my intention. It is between my competence, what I am right now, and my intention, what I really want to be, my natural acceptance. So that's the dialogue that is intended, it will start. And this has been discussed, so I won't go into much of detail. When you look at your natural acceptance, you will find that it is always for something like relationship. It is always for harmony. It is always for coexistence, you know, like that. But when you look at your competence or look at your imagination, in this case, related to relationship, sometimes it is for relationship and sometimes for opposition. So when somebody says something which you don't like, you may plan, you may spend a lot of time planning as to how you will respond or react to that person, you know, how you will take revenge and things like that. So that is the present state of affairs, what I am right now, or what you are right now. But you can take a look at it and find out whether this is the case or this is not the case. And this has been discussed, that when what you are, your imagination is in line with your natural acceptance, there is harmony in the self. There is happiness in within. And when these are in contradiction, then there is unhappiness in the self. because these are not in harmony, these are in contradiction. So the work that has to be done is number one, to discover this natural acceptance. What is my natural acceptance? What is my intention? What do I really want to be? And all that. So that is one thing. And I'm saying discover it because it is already there. It is something that every human being, every self has at the as a latent possibility. So that is always there. So you have to discover it. The second thing is to become aware of what I am, to become aware of my imagination. And to then be able to see that, is there a match between these two? If there is no match between these two, no? So through the dialogue to find out whether these are in harmony or these are in contradiction. So that is the meaning of the dialogue within. So any important questions about this, we can take one or two questions over here. This has been discussed, so perhaps there will be no questions, but if there are any, let me know. Yeah, I'm going to try to address to those people who have not, you know, spoken before. And there's also this poll that is there. So, Dr. Sandeep, please go ahead. After you answer the poll, you can.
Sir, good afternoon.
Yeah, good afternoon, Sandeep.
Sir, it is very nice to hear you and your guidance. Sir, my question is that is this natural acceptance is a conditional or it is unconditional?
Yeah, very good question. Keep that question and try to find out for yourself. So we'll keep asking these questions, right? So on the screen right now, there is this question about you want to live in relationship or you want to sometimes live with opposition. What is your answer? Is it conditional?
Obviously, sir, it is conditional.
So if it is conditional for you, it is conditional, fine. So I'm not trying to convince you. I want you to explore and find out. You may be living in opposition sometimes or most of the time or all the time, but deep within, how do you want to live? If you were given all the choice, all the possibility, how would you want to live?
Sir, is it based on our perception only?
No, no, you ask yourself, you see, this is not an academic exercise. This is something that you have to look into yourself and find out. And whatever you find out is true for you. So if it is conditional for you, that is true for you. But try to find out what is really there inside. Okay, so given all the choice, would you like to be in relationship or be in opposition? You might have 100 reasons to be in opposition, but given all the choice, what is your answer?
So, sir, I will introspect and then come to you then.
Yeah. So that's why I'm saying keep it open and keep on exploring. See, if the moment you assume something or the moment you stop exploring, you stop progressing as a human being. So find out what it is, and then you can, you know, see whether it is your intention that is lacking or it is your competence that is lacking. Because you can certainly work on your competence. Anybody can work on their competence. So keep your question open and also your mind open for the answer. But you have to discover the answer yourself. We can only give you some suggestion, some guidance, some proposal. Isn't it? Okay. Dr. Geeta?
Bhaiya, namaste, bhaiya.
Namaste.
This is also from my own personal experience, bhaiya. Yes. I can clearly say that for nearly a decade, I was having a feeling of opposition towards my spouse. And I do was having a condition that if he was nice to me, then I will also behave nicely. So that was the condition I was having with myself. And I'm also very sure, Bhaiya, that I was not able to access my natural acceptance. That is to be in relationship, that I was not able to access for such a long time, Bhaiya. So I wonder myself why I was unable to access my natural acceptance for such a long time. Only after I'm exposed to EHV, the shift began.
Yeah, so it should be part of our education.
Hmm.
But even now you can see whether that is continuous or from time to time you shift back to opposition. That is one thing. I mean, that's not the very important thing. The very important thing, if you can see, is that the moment you think about opposition, you are unhappy. Whether you express that to the other or not is immaterial. The interesting thing is that the moment you are having a feeling of opposition, you are unhappy within.
Sure, Bhaiya.
If you can see that, then you will, you know, start looking into why is it that I am going into this? Is it in my hands or not? And so on. So you'll start looking into all of that. But if you can see that the moment you are in contradiction with your natural acceptance, you means your imagination is in contradiction with your natural acceptance. The moment that happens, the same moment you become unhappy. And when you become unhappy, then you can perhaps, you know, not make anybody else also happy. So you make others also unhappy. Okay,
My question was why I was unable to access for such a long time.
That you have to answer. If you are sleeping for a long time, then, you know, you have to find out why you are sleeping for such a long time. And we may still be sleeping. I may still be sleeping, you know, partially. Sleeping in the sense that I am not aware. I am not aware of my imagination. I am not aware of my natural acceptance. And therefore, I am not having this dialogue also.
Sure, Bhaiya, I was not having the dialogue.
So we have to find out for ourselves. But that's not the important thing. Now that you have the proposal, you can find out whether it is true for you or not, whether it is meaningful or not, and start working on these three things: discovering your natural acceptance, becoming more aware of your imagination, and having this dialogue, rather than trying to find out, oh, what happened, why I was sleeping for so long, and so on.
Okay, Bhaiya. Now I am in the process.
But you are welcome to waste your time in that. There is no... You know.
Okay. Thank you, Bhaiya. I got it.
Yeah, nice. Okay, so this is one important thing that has already been discussed. So this process is a process of self-exploration, of investigating at the level of the self, and through that, evolving self-evolution. So this is the process that this course and this whole education is, we are saying, if it is this kind of process, it will lead to self-evolution, evolution of the self, which is something quite important. And if that happens, then three things will happen. Sorry. One thing that will happen is that you will know yourself. Know yourself means you will be well aware of your imagination, and you will be taking guidance for your imagination from your natural acceptance. So that dialogue will be very active. So it's a process of knowing yourself. It is a process of knowing the rest of nature and the whole existence through the self. Now, this is a very, very big proposal, but so don't, you know, just take it for granted. But whatever you know, find out whether it is through yourself or it is coming from outside without you being involved in it. So point number four is, it is a process of knowing oneself, and through the self, knowing everything else. Once you know yourself and you know something else, so then the next question is that you will be able to recognize your relationship with that entity. So if you know yourself and you know your spouse or you know other human being, then you will be able to recognize your relationship with that human being and fulfill that relationship or think about fulfilling that relationship. Without knowing the other, without knowing yourself, and without knowing your relationship, it is very difficult to fulfill the relationship. So point number five is that it is a process of being able to find out one's relationship with the other unit, with every other unit, and fulfilling that relationship. That may happen in many, many small steps, but that is the process. And if I know my relationship, I know what is the meaning of human conduct, what it is to be human, and how a human being interacts with others. So I know my value, I know my role, I know what is the meaning of human conduct. So it's a process of knowing human conduct. And when I know what is human, then I will make effort to be human, to live like human, to live with human consciousness. And all this happens very slowly through this process of self-exploration. And if these three things happen, that is 4, 5, and 6, then we can say that we are living in harmony within and living in harmony with everything else that exists. So this is the process of self-exploration and its potential outcome. Now, these are all, you know, very big proposals. So the whole course and the set of courses in universal human values are aimed towards this 4, 5, 6, and therefore 7. If I were to put it in one sentence, it is this point number 7. So let's see if there are any urgent questions related to this. We can take one or two questions. I've lowered all the hands so that we have questions pertaining to these points. Yes, Dr. Prabhakaran.
Good afternoon, Rajulji.
Good afternoon
to everyone. In this process of self-exploration, point number one, it is a process of dialogue between me and you to begin with. It soon becomes a dialogue within your own self. But what I understood within self, within your own self, should come to begin with, and then it may develop to have the dialogue between me and you. If I am wrong, please tell me, sir. I want your clarity from you in this point number one, sir.
Exactly. Yeah, I would say that if there is a dialogue going on in you already, which is very likely, you can certainly put that as a initial step, that you have questions and you are finding or you are trying to find answers to that. So whether you are finding, whether you are in that state or you are in a state where you are not not looking for any answers. Like yes. I can say for myself, there was some discomfort, but I didn't know, you know, what the question is. So whether you are exploring with a specific question or whether you are, you know, being asked to come for this workshop or something like that, those are all, you know, fine. So you can certainly put your, that you are having a dialogue within to start with. That is fine. And most people are having that. There is no doubt about it. But for the purpose of clarity, we are putting it like this. And particularly in education, the dialogue has to be there, or in the family, the dialogue has to be there between the people who are there in that family.
Okay.
And the dialogue has to be beyond the transactions. The transactions of living, you know, eat your food and brush your teeth and things like that. Those are very initial kind of things. But beyond that, the sharing of things, sharing of feelings, all that, those dialogues, and then the basic questions about human existence, all those dialogues, you know, should blossom. And that will lead to this exploration within.
Yes, sir. I got your point.
Now,
if you permit me, one more doubt. In can I,
We'll come back to you after some time.
Okay.
Professor Chandana.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Sir, yes, we can understand these things. We can have a self-exploration on this, investigate, introspect, and we can also cross-verify and validate the same. But don't you think it is a because we conduct these SIP programs where this UHV is one of the design metric for the first year engineering students. So it I often feel it is like a little bit of a challenge, sir, for the two. Yes, definitely, they are all proposals. And we start by saying that they're all proposals and we are all co-explorers. Okay. But it is a real challenge. Even with a lot of illustrations and examples, we try to put forth these proposals, but still it is a challenge to for the young generation. So what is your take on this, sir?
Have you understood this proposal yourself?
Yes, and there is a
are you free from fear of death?
Yes,
you are free from anger. Yes, you are free from all these things.
Yes, absolutely.
If you are indeed, then you'll be able to explain it to the students.
Yes, sir.
Okay, if you assume that you are but you really are not, then you will be in the state that you are explaining. Okay.
Okay.
So don't over-evaluate yourself.
Yeah.
You know, rightly evaluate yourself.
Yes.
And check it out. Keep it open.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
Because if we have understood something, then it will be in our living.
Yes.
In continuity, not sometimes and sometimes not.
Yeah, not in discontinuous way. Yes.
Yeah. Okay, so good. So keep it open and keep exploring.
Yes, sir. Okay.
What you are saying is that this is a possibility.
Yeah.
This is a human possibility.
Yeah.
If you take what is the full human potential?
Yes.
Right?
Yes, sir. Actually, because looking from the maturity point of view, we are all enough matured to understand.
Yeah, I would you know, stop you right there.
Okay, sir.
Right in the beginning, we said that look for things yourself.
Yes.
Work on yourself first.
Yes.
Okay. Don't, you are running away outside.
Yes. Yes. Understand.
You will not understand anything in this workshop if you keep running away outside.
Yes, sir.
You or anybody else.
Yes.
Okay. So if you are not focused on yourself, your own understanding, being clear about it yourself, ensuring this feeling, right understanding and right feeling in yourself, it's going to be a waste of time.
Okay, sir.
Okay. And you will not be able to reach your student, any student.
Yes, sir.
You will just be able to preach.
Yes.
After some time, they'll find out. then they will say, you know, okay, fine, there are n number of these characters, and this is one more. So it's not going to help.
Okay.
So we have said over and over again that, you know, try to look into things for yourself first.
Yes.
So try to spend the time in this workshop for your self-development.
Yes. Thank you, sir.
Then let's see what happens.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Nice.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. So this self-exploration, this self-investigation, okay, is basically about these two questions. The first question is, what is my desire? What is my aim, purpose, objective, basic aspiration, all that, you know, what do I want to achieve? So that is one question. That is the object of the self-exploration. And the second question has to do with how do I achieve what I want to achieve? So these are the two basic questions. And we keep doing this all the time. But try to find out that if these questions are important for you or not. And do you have any other questions other than what do I want to achieve and how to achieve it? So try to find out. I'll lower all the hands so you can address to this particular question. Anybody have any thoughts about these two questions? We can try to address that. Yes, Professor Deepa Nair.
Yeah, good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon, everyone. Yeah, actually my desire is what do I want to achieve? At the same time, I have to look on my present status. Then only I can think about the method for achieving it. So that's the importance of the part B, how do I achieve it? Before that, I need to be aware about my present status.
Yeah, of course you have to be aware when you see, first of all, you have to be clear about where you want to reach. What is your objective? Okay. You also have to find out where you are.
Yes, yes.
Then you have to, you know, say, okay, how do I go here? Isn't it?
Yes.
So in the question, this how do I achieve it, you have to have this part. Where you are. The problem is that we have no idea about where we want to reach. We have, you know, not much idea about that. We don't even have much idea about where we are. We have so much of over-evaluation of ourselves that we think that we are already somewhere, you know. So we don't make any progress. So if we don't have any idea about this, we don't have any idea about where we are, we keep doing something. Life is like that. But think about it, find out if it is like this or it is like this. Is it like this or is it like this?
Yeah, better we prefer to be the A.
Yeah.
Yeah, I say, actually we are B now.
Maybe, but don't be very harsh on yourself, but try to find out realistically.
Yes.
And if we are clear about this, you know, if we are clear about where we want to reach, then no matter what somebody else is doing, I will go on my path. And my path will be fulfilling for me, and it will be fulfilling for everybody else. It won't be that I don't care and, you know, I will do my thing and it doesn't matter what happens to anybody else. It won't be like that. But keep it open, find out where it is.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. So let me recall this exercise from UHV1 from the SIP. There's one exercise about why are we making this effort? So we are making so much of effort, we are studying or doing whatever, something to become something, right? When we become something, we want to do something. Like an engineer maybe wants to build bridges, or an artist wants to inspire others through music, a teacher wants to educate, all that. And by doing something, I want to get something. Some money, some name, some fame, you know, some respect, things like that. And ultimately, if we say, why are we trying to get this? The answer is, I want to be happy and I want to be prosperous. Isn't it? So we did this in the SIP, and I hope that you have gone through it and done that. So which is your basic aspiration, your goal? So let's see what it is. You can put it in the chat. Or you can unmute yourself and, you know, put it. Yeah. So it's very easy to see like this, that you want to be happy and prosperous and all that. That is my goal. Right? And this has been discussed. So So this is important, that this is my basic aspiration. This is my goal. You know, this is my final destination, whatever it is. You know, this is where I want to reach. And these, all these other things, they are steps or they are pathways. They are not the goal. But when we talk to our children, we keep saying, you know, that you should be a good engineer. That is your goal, to be a good doctor and so on. So if we are clear about this as our basic aspiration, then only we'll be able to, you know, guide others. But over here, the point is, this is our basic aspiration, and we can be clear about it, and we can be helpful to the others also. So I'm not going to spend much time on this, because this is a full lecture during the SIP, and you must have gone through the recording of it, and some of you have conducted the SIP also, so you would have that clarity. One important takeaway from that is this, that if one pathway is not available, then does your basic aspiration get blocked? Is there no way to achieve your basic aspiration? You know, so if somebody is not able to get admission into medical, and they get admission into B Pharma, is their life finished, or they can still reach their final goal? And, you know, so like that, you know, all that can be discussed when you are discussing with the students. But for yourself, are you able to see that this is your basic aspiration? And not only this happiness and prosperity, but the continuity of happiness and prosperity, which has been discussed, you know, a number of times. So we can say that, or we can see that our basic desire is to achieve this continuity of happiness and prosperity. This is what I want to achieve. This is my aim. As a human being, this is my objective. So I have to understand what this means. Without understanding what this means, I can assume something about it and never reach there. And then I have to have some program to achieve it. Some steps, some effort has to be made for that, and so on. So the self-exploration has to be focused on understanding all these things. What is the reality of happiness? What is the reality of prosperity and all that? And then the second part is the process of self-exploration. So you can explore with a guide or without a guide. And in this case, if it is a part of education, it can be with some guidance in terms of proposals, which the student can verify on their own right. And not assume it to be true or false. The moment you assume it to be true, you stop exploring. If you assume it to be false, then it is anyway gone into the dustbin. So don't assume it to be either true or false, but to verify it on your own right. And we had discussed this also, that it is a proposal to be verified. And there are two parts of the proposal. One part has to do with your natural acceptance, to verify it, if it is naturally acceptable to you or not. And the second part is experiential validation, which means either you are behaving with other human beings. If the behavior leads to mutual happiness, that proposal is right for you. And similarly, work with the rest of nature. If it leads to your prosperity and the prosperity of the rest of nature, then that proposal is right for you. So this has been discussed a number of times. If there are any important questions about this, let's take a couple of questions. Okay, so we'll go ahead. And we ask this question, which process is naturally acceptable? One where you find the answer for yourself, or where somebody else tells you the answer and you just assume it. So you can keep that open. So in this lecture, we had discussed about these things, about the content of self-exploration. That is, what is the basic human aspiration? What is my goal? What is my aim? And how to fulfill it? And the process, this process that we just discussed. So that is what we have discussed in this lecture. And this process of self-exploration may start with a dialogue between you and me, or like somebody said, that it is already there, so it may be already happening. But the dialogue is between what you are and what your natural acceptance is. If the dialogue is already going on, it's nice, and this workshop can be, or this course can be used to strengthen that dialogue. If it is not happening, then this workshop and this course can be a trigger to start that, to initiate it. And ultimately, if we are able to discover our natural acceptance and all the things, the three things that we talked about, then that leads to our self-evolution, self-development. Yes, Rupali ji.
Audible?
Yeah, now you are audible. Yes, yeah. Please go ahead.
I had one question.
Yes.
Morning, we had discussion regarding, how one can improve oneself, or how our values, they should be self-own made, or another person tells you and you, assume it. So it is true that if my quotient of natural acceptance and right understanding is increasing through my own self, that is good. But at the same time, there are some people who have better competence than me. So if they try to increase my competence, then the proportion of my natural acceptance and right understanding will be increased due to that. So is it not good to improve my value listening to them?
Yeah, so we're not saying don't listen to anybody. All we are saying is that whatever is coming from somebody else,
yeah,
you verify it on your own right.
Okay.
On the basis of your natural acceptance.
Okay. So anything you learn, you first of all, or listen, you first of all verify it for your own. and then you accept it, or you
don't accept it or reject it.
Okay.
Verify it.
Okay.
And
okay.
If it is something that you are able to verify, then you will anyway live by it.
Yeah. Yes.
It won't be forced from outside.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
So if you have understood,
yeah,
or you have verified that feeling of respect is naturally acceptable to you, then you'll always live with a feeling of respect.
Yes.
Regardless of anybody else, they may be, you know, giving all kinds of abuses to you. But you won't be bothered by it.
Yeah.
Because you have been able to verify that respect is naturally acceptable to you.
Yes.
Not begging for respect, but having the feeling of respect from within.
Within. Yeah. Okay.
So if you have been able to verify it, that's very nice. Isn't it?
Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. Now, this has been discussed earlier. So we'll discuss a few of the questions that typically come up, and I put three questions over here. So first question is, how can we say that natural acceptance is invariant with time, that it stays the same? So would anybody like to sort of comment on that? Yeah, Vinay Chidriji.
Namaste, sir.
Namaste.
Am I audible?
There's a background noise in your this thing, but you are audible.
Yeah. So natural acceptance is continuous, that we can say invariant of time.
We or I?
I'm sorry. I can say that it is invariant of time, because natural acceptance tells me that I want to be happy always. So this was there when I was a kid, this was there when I was a teenager, and this is there existing even today. And yeah, this is true for all the people, everywhere, whenever I ask anybody, does he want to be happy continuously? So the answer is yes, and that I know from my natural acceptance that everybody will have the same answer.
Right.
Yes, thank you, sir.
Yeah. Anybody else wants to give an example? Minu Mehta ji.
Namaste, bhaiya.
Namaste.
Yeah. So I would say that our desire to be happy does not change with time. Whether I am old or I am young, it doesn't change with age. It doesn't change with any of the qualifiers.
Yeah.
And happiness is a function of natural acceptance. So okay, if my ultimate objective is always to stay happy, and that does not change, and this happiness depends upon natural acceptance, then obviously natural acceptance becomes a constant. It does not change.
Very good. So you are able to see that for yourself, and you'll have to give lots of examples to yourself to verify it, you know.
Ji, bhaiya.
So try to do that.
Ji, bhaiya. Yes. So, for example, sir, if I feel that I receive happiness through food, then I explore, and what I understand is that as long as I'm eating the food, it gives me happiness. So it is temporary. Maybe then I take the example of another physical facility. So by doing these types of small explorations, I realize that happiness depends only on my natural acceptance for continuity, and that cannot be derived through physical facility. And that is how I would conclude that natural acceptance is invariant. Was I clear, sir?
Good evening. Well, I think you got muted, Rajul Bhaiya.
Hello?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The microphone was muted.
Okay. I must have touched something.
Okay.
Thank you for reminding me.
Okay. Good evening. Shall I?
Yeah, please go ahead. And then we'll go to Professor Meena.
Okay.
After you. Yeah.
Yeah. See, if I am asking my natural acceptance whether I want relationship, my natural acceptance says yes, relationship is needed at any time I ask, any time, today, tomorrow, yesterday, any time my natural acceptance says that I want a relationship. And if I'm asking my natural acceptance whether I want to have good health or I want to nurture my body, so for that, every time I'm getting the same answer, right? So by that, we can say my natural acceptance is for is invariant with time.
Okay. So you have a natural acceptance to nurture your body.
Nurture your body for relationship, having a good relationship.
Natural acceptance for, well, you are putting some adjective there.
No, relationship.
Okay, for relationship. I'll
relationship.
Say okay. To live in relationship.
Yes.
And that good relationship means something and will.
No, relationship only.
Yeah. No, it means something, and we have to understand what it means into a fair amount of detail so that it can come into living. Otherwise, all these things will become like, nice do's and don'ts, isn't it?
With all the nine feelings, recognition of the feelings and fulfillment of the feelings.
Yeah, the feelings, feeling of relationship. And then responsibility in the relationship and all that, all that will be part of this, what good means or what relationship means.
Okay,
very nice. Very nice. Yes, Professor Meena.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Sir, to say that the natural acceptance is invariant with the time, see, sir, for example, we have our own ambition, our own desire, and the intention of all that, achieving them is all to be happiness only, to be happy and prosperous.
Yes.
But here, when I choose the path to reach that ultimate happiness, what we say, the basic aspiration, so the path should have in such a way that whatever the concerns I come across there should always be based upon the natural acceptance only. So,
very good. Yes.
If that is not taken care of, because then there is no meaning in myself be happy at the end, saying that where I have neither maintained the harmony nor taken care of my surrounding. So that will not help. So resolving the concern should always be based upon the natural acceptance, which gives us the right understanding and also the harmony. So if that is done, then the natural acceptance is taken care. So if that is the one to be done, then the natural acceptance is definitely invariant, not for years or whatever it is. It is the same if it is for 100 years, thousands years, and that attitude will remain the same, sir. So it is always invariant with the time.
Very true.
Thank you, sir.
And your very important point that you brought up is that all these, it has to lead to harmony at all the levels.
Yes, yes. Almost we should try our best there.
Nature and existence.
Yes, sir.
So it has to lead to harmony at all these four levels. Oh, so this is three.
You have to take care of the concerns in such a way that all these are involved there.
Yes.
Yes.
So it's a tall order, but we can explore and find out and see if it is, we may be living partially like that, partially otherwise, and so on. But if we are able to see that this is the possibility, then we'll make effort for it.
Yes.
Isn't it?
Yes, sir, definitely.
Yeah. Very nice.
Thank you, sir.
We have been exploring.
A little bit from all these, this one, sir. It's all because due to these workshops.
Yeah, so it has to become a part of our living.
Yes.
And then it will become, you know, continuous. Whatever bit of it is understood, it becomes continuous. Whatever bit of it is assumed, it has no chance or not much chance of becoming continuous.
Yes, sir.
You know, so we have to go to understanding.
Yes, sir.
Very nice.
Thank you, sir.
Then there is this thing about acceptance and natural acceptance. So let's see. We have put this difference between acceptance and natural acceptance. And let's see if there are any observations about this, that you may accept something because it is required in the society and things like that, which may not be naturally acceptable to you, but you accept it. Does that happen? You can, you know, have things that you accept under peer pressure, but it may not be naturally acceptable to you. Things that we are dependent on the outside and sometimes mostly on our own inside, you know, our own tastes, our own sanskars, our own preconditioning.
Yeah.
Yeah. So Vinay Chidri would like to say something.
Yeah, when I was young, my father, whenever we get used to get hurt by falling down or like that, so we start crying and or we try to be worried. So father used to say that don't focus on your pain. If you don't focus, it will not pay, give you pain. It will automatically become, the intensity will be lower. But that time I don't use me say, I used to think that he's just saying like that for that I should not try. But when I did this exercise of observing the body through.
Let's stick to natural acceptance and acceptance. So yeah, when we so come there, to the there, body, we'll do that. Yeah.
So yeah. There I could understand that my body and my self, we are different and I take the decision. Whenever I find it important, I get the sensation and I feel it important, then I focus on it. If I don't focus it on it, I don't get that sensation intensely. So it is because of this understanding I relate to that.
Okay, okay. Good. If you can relate it to that, that is nice. Any examples of acceptance which is not naturally acceptable?
Namaste, sir.
Yeah, namaste, Rahul. Any examples sir, of...
Yes, sir. There is a great difference between natural acceptance and acceptance. Because most of the time, there is a confusion of this natural acceptance and acceptance because while formulating the proposal, it is whether it is a true or it is a, if it is not a right kind of proposal, then we'll have a confusion or like we don't have a clarity on the natural acceptance. Like, for example, taking the food, say for example, taking rice is a right proposal or taking roti is a right proposal. So ultimately, the right proposal is to take whatever is to nurture our body. So that kind of a proposal is a universal proposal, so that we'll validate it and that will be naturally acceptable. Not that roti sometimes for the different regions, different places, depending upon the conditions, it may vary. But as far as the proposal is concerned to nurture the body, definitely it will be naturally acceptable. So formulating the question proposal is also important, and also so acceptance and natural acceptance are different. So
So over here you can find out what is naturally acceptable. So for example, when you ask this question about feeling, it is very easy to say yes, this feeling is naturally acceptable or not acceptable. But when you are talking about, you know, like something which has to do with the outside, like eating rice or roti, right?
Yes, sir.
That you won't be able to do. If you have to do with something like purpose, or if you have something to do with your role or participation, then yes, you can answer these questions. But when you are asking these kind of questions, you can't find the answer from your natural acceptance.
No, sir. Just I was asking that whenever you take our food to nurture our body or to harm our body. So that is definitely naturally acceptable, that is to nurture our body. So that is the natural acceptance.
Yeah, you can certainly get this answer from your natural acceptance to nurture the body. But this is how to nurture the body. So for some bodies, it may be the wheat that is more suitable. For some bodies, it may be the rice that is more suitable. In certain weather, it might be rice. In certain weather, it might be roti, etc.
Yes, sir. So that is the acceptance, like it differs. Sir. The acceptance. So it differs from person to person, but the natural acceptance is common, universal, and is common to all.
So when you look at this set, there is a definite set of things that you can answer. Okay. So we have taken these examples of feeling, of nurturing the body, like you are rightly pointing out. Sometimes we eat things which are tasty, but they may not be nurturing for the body. But we are taking them because that taste makes us happy for some time at least. Then we get heartburn and all that. That might be the side effect of that and all that. And you can also find out. Yes. Please go ahead.
No, on a lighter note, just for the coloring the hair, okay. My natural acceptance is nothing is there, nothing of that. If I am leaving the hair white also, that is nothing to add to my respect or not. But yeah. The circumstances and the preconditioning, that makes me to go for coloring. So,
yeah, that is very good example. Yeah. And you will find that it is not somebody else's preconditioning. It is your preconditioning.
Yes. And sometimes others also say that is not suiting you. So your dresses and your hair. So why are you coming like this? You are not looking like that when they are telling. So it automatically.
Yes. Very true. Yes. So let's
Can I add one more note, sir?
Yeah, so sure, go ahead.
Yeah, when I say natural acceptance, I prefer cooking and I love cooking. If it is to say that you have to cook early in the morning, 4 o'clock, you have to get up and cook for the entire family and then go catch the bus. So that is acceptance. So cooking,
it naturally. Cooking, it will be, you know, you are concerned about nurturing the body of your family.
Yeah, right.
This is your natural acceptance. Okay.
But if it is under some pressure, the circumstances, so in that case, it is acceptance.
Yes.
I'm ready to nurture my family, but not with the, some constraints or some influential parameters.
Exactly. So this influence or this force from outside is not very naturally acceptable.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. True. True.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So we ask this question, you know, respect elders or respect all. So you can actually, when you ask the right question, somebody pointed out that when you ask the right question, you are able to see whether it is naturally acceptable or just acceptable. Isn't it? So respect elders, you certainly accept it. But when you say respect all, then you say, oh, yeah, this is naturally acceptable.
Hi, Chilama.
Hi, Mom.
Yeah, so we have...
Hello.
We have some some background noise, so I'll just mute. Okay. So when you look at this acceptance and natural acceptance, you can see that acceptance may be under some circumstances, under some influence, and it may keep changing with time, place, and person. It is indefinite. And it may lead to happiness or unhappiness. May lead means if you live by that, it may lead to happiness and or it may lead to unhappiness. Not very sure. But when it comes to natural acceptance, it is your innate nature. It is something which is inseparable from you. If you are able to access it, you will be able to see what it is. And it doesn't change with time, not with place, not with person. It is also definite and uncorrupted by your preconditioning. So some idea about natural acceptance and acceptance you can have, you know, look into it for yourself and try to conclude about it for yourself.